I have to tell you, Jake, we were so overwhelmed. Jerry Simonson and I, the cameraman with me, by everything that we saw. But most of all, Jake, we were overwhelmed by the trauma these people are feeling and everything they have gone through and have yet to go through. Take a listen.
It is so much worse than they had feared. The Abaco Islands, forever scarred now by mass destruction, home after home, entire rooftops blown away, debris scattered in unrecognizable heaps, boats tossed like confetti. The images belie the obvious question, how could anyone survive this?
Oh my God. Can't we get here? Okay.
I'm Paula.
You're okay.
We arrived by helicopter in Man O' War in Abaco with Billy Aubrey, embracing his wife Shauna after days of not knowing if she was dead or alive. Shauna hunkered down with friends in their seaside home until the roof blew off, and they all scrambled to find anything still standing.
So Nancy, this is what kept you guys alive, this little bathroom?
This little room kept us alive. This is it. We came in and hunkered down, and Shauna was on the ground crying, and we were just trying to...
That was hysterical.
What did it sound like in here at the time?
Oh, it was loud. There was a lot of crashing. Remember all the crashing and banging and whirling.
And stuff we thought was coming through this wall.
So many in the Abaco Islands lived through hours that resembled a horror movie, exposed to winds that topped 215 miles an hour, like tornadoes touching down every minute.
Words can't describe it. I don't wish it on nobody. Nobody. Words can't describe it. They could never categorize this. Never.
My grandfather ran out.
It was like an atomic bomb went off.
Residents here tell me their little island paradise is unrecognizable even to them. They're resourceful and self-reliant, they say, but they could have never imagined a storm as powerful as Dorian.
You know, there's no better way to describe to you the force of Hurricane Dorian to be right here where people rode out the storm in their living rooms, in their dining rooms. I mean, look at this. The roof blew off the house here. The entire kitchen came down. Their refrigerator ended up here on the ground. Their living room and dining room furniture is strewn all over. People describe these things being tossed around the island like projectiles. They all cowered, hovered in their bathrooms, in closets, anything they could find to take shelter.
There are now the beginnings of recovery, but only the basics. Medical attention, private helicopters to take out those who are sick, the elderly, young families.
I'm sure it'll never be the same again. The people are strong here, and we're going to try to do our best to rebuild the best way we can, but we know it'll never be the same.
This was a storm of biblical proportions, Abaconians tell me. And yes, they worry. It will take a miracle to recover from it all.
And Jake, think about everything that we just heard, everything we just saw. You can repeat that thousands of times over. Spoke to a man from another island in Abaco who told me that there was a storm surge. He had gone under. His son reached out to hold him up. He really wanted to let go. He couldn't take any more. But he said, no, I'm not going to let my son see me die this way. And he got himself out of there. Sorry, Jake.
So tough. Paula, you were not supposed to spend the night on the Abaco Islands. What happened?
So we're at a staging area here in Nassau, and there are flights everywhere. They just couldn't get us back. With the way the air conditions, the airline traffic, the helicopter traffic, obviously, there was a problem. It's so difficult, Jake, on the island I was on. I mean, they cleared the baseball field so that we could land, so that we could get ourselves in, Billy in, and get that to that kind of reunion and get some supplies in. So we had to stay there. You know, these people in Man O' War, they had been through so much, and yet they didn't blink an eye. We said, we'll sleep on the beach. We'll sleep on the grass. We don't care. No, they took us in. And a special thank you to Marcia and Angel Cruz. I know they have relatives in Florida. Thank you so much. And what we saw there is what people are grappling with right now. Of course, Jake, they're thankful. They're thankful for being alive. But when you see the way they are living, I mean, they took all the food out of the refrigerator, the cruises, cooked it. That's all they really have. They have some more provisions in the grocery store. But they're wondering what comes next. Their kids are supposed to start school. And it's things like that that this island is beginning to grapple with. And Jake, there's more. On this island, things are fairly under control. People are starting to worry about things like disease. They hear the death reports and say that will inevitably go up, and they are starting to worry about unrecovered bodies, things like cholera. So much to worry them at this place. And as they were told us on the island, Jake, they worry that they won't be able to return, at least not in the fashion that they were there now, living there full time.